Police and the army deployed heavily around Kampala today to forestall planned protests against corruption in government and parliament by youth. Armored vehicles and personnel patrolling the streets were a significant display of deterring security forces towards groups intending to march in protest. Key roads leading to parliament, including Nile Avenue, Siadi Barre Avenue, De Winton Road, were also cordoned off by security forces. Access to these roads was restricted, with public vehicles barred from entering. Only pedestrians were permitted to pass through, subject to rigorous security checks. A robust security presence was also evident at key roundabouts in Kampala, marked by the deployment of armored vehicles and personnel. Youth who attempted to demonstrate from various spots were met with the full force of prepared anti-riot police.
Corruption, stop! Stop! Corruption, stop! Stop! Corruption, stop!
Stop! Corruption, stop! Corruption, stop!
To mimic methods used by their counterparts in Kenya, where the youth, popularly referred to as Gen Z, pushed President William Ruto to drop the controversial finance bill 2024 and sack the cabinet, Ugandans have been mobilizing online. On the contrary, the Ugandan security forces have not left anything to chance, unleashing all necessary deterrence measures towards the intended demonstrations. Police in Iganga district have launched an investigation into a road crash that claimed the National Resistance Movement vice chairperson in charge of Karamoja sub-region, Simon Alepei, this morning. Busoga East police spokesperson Diana Nandaula said the crash happened at Bukona village, Nakalama sub-county, along the Mbale Tirini highway at around 1 a.m. She added that Alepei, who was a lone occupant of his Land Cruiser, registration number UAP787Q, is suspected to have collided with an unidentified vehicle that forced him off the road, resulting in his death. Alepei's vehicle, which was coming from Bali, collided with an unknown motor vehicle that was coming from Iganga. Alepei died on spot, according to a statement from the Busoga East Region Police. Rose Bakita, the assistant NRM chairperson in the Eastern Region, has expressed sadness about the loss of the vice chairperson NRM for Karamoja.
Of course, we are very saddened because when only chairperson of we lost the late Honorable Jacob Olanya. May his soul rest in peace. We've not yet replaced the one for Northern Region. Now we've lost the one for Karamoja. It's really saddening and a very sad moment for everybody.
Police have transferred the deceased body to Mulago National Referral Hospital for a post-mortem and towed his vehicle to Iganga Police Yard pending inspection. Alepei, who served as the Moroto Municipality Legislator in the last parliament, has been the vice chairperson for the ruling National Resistance Movement for the Karamoja sub-region and a Central Executive Committee member. Butale Jet District leaders have resolved to aid the people of Hisiro Island in Nawanjofu sub-county with a bridge to ease movement to and from the island. With only one canoe and a population of 1,000 settlers, Hisiro Island is inaccessible. This, according to residents, has led to increased school dropouts since pupils find it difficult to cross the water to access school. Residents reported that several people have also died while attempting to cross River Manafwa to access social services. As a leader, I have lost a child while crossing that bridge. Besides that, we have lost four adult men at the same spot because we lack a bridge. During an inspection of the roads, Geoffrey Mutiwa, the MP for Bunyule West constituency, revealed that the Minister of Works intends to construct 100 bridges across the country. He hopes Hisiro Island residents will benefit from this United Kingdom grant.
Today we are having two activities. One, we are doing what we call monitoring of government programs, especially in the road sector. We are looking at roads that have just been constructed and those that are, the district is still working on.
The district leaders also moved to other places in the district to inspect roadworks and account for the 1 billion shillings that was granted to the district for rehabilitation of roads in the financial year 2023-2024.